What is up, everyone? Appreciate you checking out the video. Right now, it is 9:13 on a Monday morning, and I'm just getting out of bed. You can see that that's legit because the bedhead is real. But full day ahead of us. We got a day in the life vlog planned as well. Couple things. So you're probably wondering, you know, it's 9, Dave. Why are you just getting going now? Actually, I've kind of found a schedule for myself that really works, and that's staying up late. Last night I was up till like 1:30, just doing various work things. It's a time where everything's, you know, chill and quiet. I don't have a lot of people blowing up my phone. I'm not as tempted to be on my phone just because there's less going on. And I think that's working out for me a lot. Another thing that I want to talk about, kind of going off the cuff here, but a lot of people in my videos or like when I do Instagram story videos, they talk about what are these papers on your door just kind of randomly chilling here. So I will zoom in on those real quick. And I actually made those goals pretty close to when I moved back to Ohio in January. I've achieved almost all of them for this year, which is a cool feeling. And we do still have a month and a half left of this year, which means there's more work to be done. So that's what you're gonna see a little bit of today, you know. What I do is I live my dream, but working. I'll explain a little bit of some of the daily tasks I have to do. We're gonna get some training in and some food in. So it's gonna be a good day. Now, if y'all wouldn't mind, before we get into the meat and potatoes of the vlog, hit that like button. Hit me with a subscribe so you can stay up to date with all of the videos I'm posting. And if you really wanna go the extra mile, hit that notification bell as well. It does help me grow the channel. Check out the links in my description. We got the trainer scoop, we got my website. I have an ebook out. Really appreciate y'all. Let's get into it. So first things first, what I always like to do in the morning is make a little bit of a breakfast and kind of prep my food for the day. So what I'm about to do is keep it super simple. Just make some eggs and toast. Get a good little first meal in here in the morning. And then like I said, I'm prepping other meals, getting stuff ready for the rest of my day. You might notice quite often I have a little earbud in. I always like to listen to something kind of like personal development or motivational in the morning. I feel like it just helps me get on a good start for the day. After getting the meals together, after eating, I always like to start off with a walk. Show you what we're looking at outside. It looks a little chilly, but it looks like a very nice morning at the same time. Through the screen, we actually got our first snow in Ohio. So I am looking forward to going out, getting this day going. And then it's right to work. Just ate that breakfast, and the part of my morning routine that I like to do just to kind of lay the framework for the day, I'll typically do this while I'm sitting next to the fire and eating that breakfast. And that's just hop on my notes app and type up a simple to-do list. I think this goes a really long way of keeping you on track, giving you a framework of what you're doing for the day, whether it be, you know, you have a legitimate job and they're telling you what to do. You type it down, you write it down, and it keeps you on track. Or if you're like me and you kind of got to figure out your own plan of action, that's where it really comes in handy, I imagine, at least. I'm going to ramble off all the things I have to do. So I'm programming for my online clients. I'm training a client in person out at the gym. I'm working out myself. Got to get my meal prep going. I like to go on 2 walks a day, 15 minutes each. So 30 minutes of cardio, even on the bulk. I'm gonna meal prep. I gotta do a little bit of back-end work for a group that I'm a part of, uploading some video, real quick stuff. And then I got my t-shirts. So I'm about to go out and take this walk, get some sunlight, get some cardio in. I'll catch you out there. All right, everybody, out here on this walk. It's 40 degrees in Ohio. We got some snow on the ground because we got a lot of snow yesterday. But still a beautiful fall day today. So I wanted to talk about a couple different things as I take this walk and awkwardly hold a video camera. And it's something that's kind of been like weighing on me and my life. Hopefully it can help you too. And that is having a vision. I mentioned earlier in the video actually, when I was talking about those goals, that I wrote those down right from the jump when I moved back to Ohio. That was a big transition for me, right? Moved to New Jersey like a year and a half after I graduated from Ohio State, and that didn't end up working out. Life happened, but I moved back, and that gave me the opportunity to do something that I always wanted to do, and do something that was on that goal sheet, which was start my own gym. Crazy that it's kind of a thing that I have people constantly hit me up like, yo, can I come train? I make money out of it because I train personal training clients. So very blessed to have been able to do that. But that's achieving a goal. Maybe you lose that 10 pounds of fat. You achieved your goal. Where do you go from there? And that's something I've been really dealing with probably since like June and July, when the gym first got jumping, started doing those open gyms, spreading awareness. Where do you go from there? And that's where having a vision comes in. I haven't really had a vision lately. Moving back to your hometown, especially when you're kind of in this area where I am, where I went from Columbus, Ohio, million plus people, to New Jersey, like the most population dense state in the world, or in the country perhaps. Maybe I'm wrong on that statistic. And then you go to all of this, the wide open, not a lot to do. Barnes, you know, it has a lot of perks, but it's drastically different from the lifestyle that I kind of came to love, being out of Ohio State and being close to big cities. I really didn't know what my move was. I still 100% don't, but that vision is starting to become so much more clear, and it feels like a weight lifted off my chest, to be honest with you. And what do I mean by that? I feel like I just have a path to go on. If you're just kind of going through, whether it be life or fitness, without a clearly defined long-term path, beyond maybe, like I said, that 10 pounds of weight loss, maybe your long-term goal is, I want to do like a bodybuilding show or a powerlifting meet. Beyond those things, I think it's important to have an idea of what you really want in your life. What are some things that I want in my life? That's what I've been thinking about, which is a deep subject. I'm not going to get into everything, but the first one that really comes to mind is impact. Like, I was able to improve my self-confidence so much through fitness, and having a platform, whether it be online or at the gym, to help people do that, to help realize their potential, something that I majorly love to do. And then number two, my vision is to kind of like educate, help people avoid some of the mistakes that I made in the past. We got dark, we're in the shade. And that's where I really think pursuing this whole YouTube thing can help me impact and educate. I've always loved YouTube since like 2006. I've been on YouTube. I used to watch like those basketball trick shot videos when I was in like fourth grade. I used to play Pokemon and watch how-to videos about Pokemon, get on message boards on YouTube. I feel like it's such a cool platform to share ideas, to spread awareness for different things. And it's something that I've dabbled in, you know, improved my quality of video over the years, but I never really went all in because this shit's not easy. That's the bottom line. I never have really dedicated myself to that. So my goal this time around is I want to dedicate myself to YouTube, impacting people, educating people without having to sacrifice relationships, friendships, work-life balance, workout-life balance, enjoying myself, playing video games, all things that I sacrificed in the past. And that's my goal this time around. I'm putting it out there. And I appreciate y'all for listening to this, because these are my things. But I encourage you to think of your things. Really challenge yourself to define, what do I want to do? Who do I want to be? And I feel like it's going to make a big impact. It's not an easy thing to do. It just takes some time. It takes some intentional thinking. So that's what I'm going to leave you with today.
And we're gonna get into a little bit of work and then we're training.
All right, popping on real quick to show y'all the pre-workout meal. We got a solid pre-workout meal. Pre-workout meal might be my favorite meal of the day. You gotta keep it carb heavy, you gotta get some protein, and it's gonna fuel you to do great. So, protein pancake. I use the Birch Benders pancake mix, throw a little bit of chocolate chips in there, make it with some egg whites, splash of almond extract. Money every time. Sugar-free maple syrup. I got a protein shake as well, Optimum Nutrition, you know, the standard stuff. And then over here, I have my pre-workout. I brought up the container. It is the Morphogen, Alphagen, high energy pre-workout. This thing has the most impressive ingredient label list I've ever seen. Look at this, look at this. It's insane, try it out. Time to eat this, and then we're gonna go train. All right, Corey, what's about to go down?
We're taking a fucking shot of pre-workout today. Cheers.
Out here in the gym, about to get a pull day down. Believe it or not, Gavin just pulled up as well. So we got a squad today. Some heavy hitters out here. Look at we got the mailman. We got Gavin. We got the dogs.
What up, boy?
All right, we got the squad. Gavin and Corey, pull day, about to go down. It's gonna be a good one. We're starting off with some rack pulls, right?
Yeah.
Rack pulls, pull ups. So, yeah, if we need them, assist if we need them. Some rows, some rear delts, and Corey's gonna hit 10 by 10 on biceps.
Let's get it. Come on, six, go. Yeah, buddy. I swear this man's not human. Yes, sir. Get it. Good fucking rep. Somebody come get this man, Joe. 15 quality, come on. Control him. There you go. Come on. Give me six. Five, come on. Four, let's get it. You got it, come on. Three, come on. Two, let's work, come on. Two more. There you go. Yeah. Let's go. shit, Corey. Good shit, Gavin, let's go. Good shit, Court, let's go. Yup.
Drive the elbows, come on. Relax the shoulders, bring them down. There you go. Perfect.
Let's go, Gavin.
Alrighty, everybody, we are back inside from that pull session. Got a little bit of time before I train a client. And like I said, I'm underprepared today. Didn't have my meal prep on point. If you follow me on Instagram, you know my post-workout meal is typically some chicken, maybe a little bit of sauce on that chicken, and then kid cereal. I typically do Fruity Pebbles, Cocoa Pebbles. Don't have any of that today. So we're getting weird with it. And this is a new concoction I'm trying out. Basically, I needed 100 grams of carbs, quick hitting carbs, simple sugars type deal. So what I did in this blender, I don't know if this is going to taste good or not. We have orange juice, a banana, and then frozen yogurt. Basically, this meal, well, you're probably like, what is this combination? It has 40 grams of protein, 11 grams of fat, and 100 carbs on the dot. So it fits perfectly. I'm going to taste test this to see how it ends up, but I'm excited to try this concoction. It's always fun to try something new every once in a while, and why not do it for the vlog? So I'm going to blend this up and let you know how it tastes. Alrighty, I have the shake poured up in the glass. If you're from Urbana, you know. We're gonna try it out. First impressions, it smells fairly good. So yeah, here's the first sip. Hold up. That's so good, I'm not gonna lie. Orange juice, banana, Kroger frozen yogurt, 100 grams of carbs, that's all I'm gonna say. Alrighty, I have to do a couple dishes, clean up, get ready for this client. Client, grocery store, online programming. It's been a crazy day, but we're gonna keep going. Alrighty, everybody, back out in the gym again after my workout. Now it's time to train a client. So I'm getting everything set up for her. Gonna do a full body workout for this client. Something I like to do for people that work out less than three or less times a week, I should say. But in the meantime, I like to put up polls on my Instagram. So I'm gonna go through and respond to some of those polls. It's a fun time. And alrighty, everybody, it is 5 o'clock. Just finished up with my client. She killed it, as she always does. The day is far from over though. So I'm about to take a quick walk as dusk is setting in, which you can kind of see through the windows here. Gotta go to the grocery store, do a little bit of meal prepping. Shouldn't take too crazy long, but then I'm gonna settle down, probably 8, grind out some work for a couple hours, and go to bed. You know, once again, I said I've really been enjoying this more evening-oriented schedule. And it's super nice. It's super nice for me. It might not work for you, but I don't have a spiel for you for this walk. I'm gonna catch you once I get back from the grocery store. Gonna do a little grocery haul overview type deal. Alrighty, guys. I got hungry before heading to the grocery store, and you all know that's a terrible idea. So we're going to get these calories in. I gotta get 3,500 calories in today. PBJ, protein shake. Quick and easy snack, especially if you don't have your meals prepped. So I'm gonna get this snack in. I gotta put up an Instagram post. You know I gotta stay active on the socials. And then it's grocery store time. It's 5:45. I'm hoping to wrap everything up by like 11 tonight. That's the goal. Been a long day, but it's a great day. Feeling good. Hope you're enjoying the vlog so far. And I'm about to head to the store. All right, everybody, we are back from the grocery store. Rainy night, snowy night, I guess more so. 8 o'clock. Time to cover this grocery haul real quick. However, we're gonna go from right to left here at the table. I'm joined by none other than my mom, who's working diligently, and my rice cooker. Alrighty, here on the right side, if you want to bulk, you gotta buy in bulk. So we have my cereal that I eat post-workout, hash browns that I eat pre-workout. We got the Birch Benders pancake mix, a bang, never had the peach mango flavor. Dad's in the mix. Got my chicken breast, 4 cans of orange juice, some maple syrup, because we're trying to get those carbs in, 2% milk, egg whites, some of this microwavable pasta, which is unbelievably convenient, followed up by, not chocolate chips, but candy chocolate chips that I put in my pancakes, once again, bulking season, pasta sauce, protein bars, got some raspberries buried under here, some salsa that I like to mix in. Big old thing of coffee grounds. We got the Starbucks breakfast blend. Some yogurt and some Pam. Because sometimes you just have to cook fat free. So it is time to meal prep for a little bit. Probably not gonna do the whole shebang tonight, but I will do more grilling and such tomorrow. But we gotta put this away because it's thawing out. Oh man, alrighty everybody. We are completely meal prepped. It's about 10 o'clock and I'm wrapping up the day. I do have a little bit more work to do. So I'm gonna chill here in the chair and knock out a little bit of work for the online clients and grind a little bit on this logo. Probably not gonna finish it, but checked off almost all of the things on my to-do list today. We're about to wrap it up with the final few things. I checked off almost everything on my to-do list today. We're about to wrap it up over these next 2 hours and get some good sleep. Guys, I really appreciate you all so much for watching the video. I hope you were able to take a little bit about the vision part. Hope you enjoyed the workout edit that we did. And a little bit about my grocery haul as well. I combined a lot of different things in this video. So if you made it this far, I do appreciate you. If, by chance, you want to learn a little bit more about my approach to nutrition, I do have an ebook, which I'll throw up a picture right here, called Using Macronutrients to Achieve Your Goals. It's a pretty dope ebook that walks you step by step through setting your own calorie intake based on your goals and then breaking that calorie intake into different macronutrients, protein, carbs, and fat that you can use to create a successful diet for yourself. Let's be real, meal plans are unsustainable, but if you can create a plan that works for you, that's where you're gonna see results. So you can check that book out. Link is down in the description. And I will say, guys, there's videos to accompany every part of the guide, so it's super easy. Check it out. If you're new, I'd really appreciate that you subscribed, hit that notification bell if you're trying to do the most. And then, of course, like the video just to show some support and help me grow this channel. Guys, I appreciate y'all so much. I'll catch you in the next video.